Many companies are making smart products. Smart ACs, smart fridges, smart TVs, smart sockets even. But if the smartness that you require is just to switch your product on and off, then we've made just the right product. Smart fingers. So the idea was, why not make a thing that can be placed in front of any plug point so that you can control it as a smart device from your phone, from anywhere in the world. For example, if you keep forgetting to put off the water pump at home, use smart fingers to put off the motor. Not just that, we used an open source app and made it an IoT product. So you can not only switch a button on and off, you can even schedule it amongst other things. Shramik took on the brief, and now he will explain the electronics behind the smart fingers. Hi.
We will make our smart finger circuit on a breadboard. Place a Arduino Nano in the breadboard. Then take a GSM SIM900A module with the SIM card inserted. For powering the GSM module, connect 5V from the Arduino to the VCC pin of the GSM module. Next, connect the ground pin from the Arduino to the ground pin of the GSM module. Now, we will make the connection through which the GSM module will communicate with the Arduino. The TX from the Arduino is connected to 5V RX of the GSM module. Next, the RX from the Arduino is connected to the TX of the GSM. Next, we require a high power servo motor. Connect some jumper cables to the motor pin, red for 5V and black for ground. Plug in the ground pin from the servo into the negative rail of the breadboard and the VCC pin from the servo into the positive rail of the breadboard. Plug in a jumper cable into the control pin of the servo and connect it to the pin 11 of the Arduino, which is an PWM output. Now, for the power supply, cut a USB cable and solder two wires. Plug in the red wire into the positive rail of the breadboard and black wire into the negative rail. A common ground should be connected from negative rail of the breadboard to the ground pin of the Arduino. Plug in the USB power supply to the Arduino Nano and this completes the circuit. The basic principle behind the circuit is, when an SMS is sent from the smartphone, the GSM module receives the information and transmits it to the Arduino. The Arduino processes this information and sends it to the servo motor to rotate. Now, plug in the two USB cables into two separate 5V adapter and connect them to an AC supply. Now, when you send an SMS from your mobile, the servo motor starts rotating.
#A1 is for on, #A0 is for off.
Now, for the app control switch circuit, place a 7805 regulator into the breadboard. Connect the positive terminal of a 10 microfarad capacitor to the first pin of the regulator and the negative terminal to the second pin of the regulator. Connect another 10 microfarad capacitor to the second and the third pin of the regulator. Now, connect a jumper cable from the first pin of the regulator with the positive rail of the breadboard. Connect another jumper cable from the regulator to the negative rail of the breadboard. Plug in two jumper cables for servo power into the second and the third pin of the regulator. Now, we require a Wi-Fi shield to connect to the internet. Plug in a jumper cable from the VIN pin of the shield to the positive rail of the breadboard and the ground pin to the negative rail of the breadboard. Take a servo motor and fix a rotating wheel on top of it. Plug in some jumper cables into the servo pin, black for ground, red for 5V, and green for control. Now attach the red wire from the motor to the third pin of the regulator and the black wire to the second pin of the regulator. Next, connect the control pin of the motor to the GPIO pin of the Wi-Fi module. The working principle behind this circuit is, when we press the button on the mobile app, the information is received by the Wi-Fi shield over the internet. This information is processed and sent to the servo motor. A 5V regulator is used to power the servo motor from the 9V power supply. Next, take a 9V 2A adapter and plug in the red wire into the positive rail and the black wire into the negative rail. Connect the adapter into an AC supply. Open the cayenne app on your smartphone and click on the device you have connected. This will open a dashboard with the switch button. Now, on clicking the switch button, the servo motor will rotate.